Hi, I am Dr. Alok Kumar. The title of my recently accepted manuscript for publication in the International Journal of Clinical Medicine Insights, Diabetes, Endocrinology and Diabetes is Parathyroidectomy Ameliorates Glucose Control and Blood Pressure in a Patient with Primary Hyperparathyroidism, Type 2 Diabetes and Hypertension. In the literature, the effect of parathyroidectomy on glucose control and blood pressure is controversial. We reported a case in whom the correction of hyperparathyroidism resulted in improvement of glucose control and blood pressure. A 52-year-old female with type 2 diabetes and hypertension for last 5 years visited our clinic with vague complaints like fatigue and generalized body pain. She attributed her symptoms to uncontrolled glucose levels and high blood pressure. For managing her glucose levels, she was taking tablet glycoside 60 mg modified release twice daily, tablet metformin sustained release 1000 mg twice daily, voglibose 0.3 mg twice daily, and a DPP-4 inhibitor sitagliptin 100 mg once a day. And to manage her blood pressure, she was taking an ARB olmesartan 40 mg once a day, hydrochlorothiazide 12.5 mg once a day, and an alpha blocker carvedilol 3.125 mg twice daily. Her HbA1c was 11.9% and her blood pressure was 160 systolic and 90 diastolic, which was high. In order to manage her glucose levels, we decided to discontinue tablet glycoside and tablet voglibose, and we added insulin premix 30:70 ratio. And to further control her blood pressure, we added a calcium channel blocker amlodipine 5 mg once a day. While going through our old medical records, we noticed a value of high serum calcium. We rechecked her serum calcium levels and serum PTH, parathyroid hormone levels. Both values of serum calcium and PTH were high. We made a diagnosis of primary hyperparathyroidism. The ultrasonography of the neck confirmed a well-defined oval hypoechoic mass posterior to the right lobe of thyroid, which was later confirmed by parathyroid scan. This patient underwent right inferior parathyroidectomy, and the histological examination of the nodule showed that it was a parathyroid adenoma. In this patient, after a few weeks after surgery, we had to taper the doses of insulin, and eventually we stopped insulin after a few weeks due to frequent episodes of hypoglycemia. And we could also stop antihypertensive medicines in this patient. We concluded that in patients with type 2 diabetes with vague complaints like fatigue, body pain and refractory hypertension, as a part of diagnostic workup, the clinicians should also check their serum calcium levels and PTH to rule out hyperparathyroidism. Because the correction of hyperparathyroidism may result in improvement of hypertension and glucose control. Thank you.